Hello students, hope you all are fine. As we have done our previous lesson, Democratic Republic of Congo, now we are going to start the next lesson, that is lesson number 5, page number 30. The lesson name is The Land of Snow, Greenland. Like the previous lesson, today also I will read the lesson along with I will explain it. Let's start the lesson. The Land of Snow, Greenland. The region around the North Pole and the South Pole are called the polar regions. Both these regions are extremely cold. There is little or no dust in the polar regions. Rainfall is extremely scanty. The polar regions are barren because of the scanty rainfall. Very low temperature and the ice cover on land. Arctic is the region of continuous cold around the North Pole. It includes the Arctic Ocean, thousands of islands, and the northern parts of the continents of Europe, Asia, and North America. People long believed that the Arctic was a very cold, icy, and snow-covered, barren place where human beings could not live. But later explorers found that except for Greenland, 9/10 of all Arctic lands have no snow and ice in summer. The sun never shines on much of the Arctic during the winter, but it shines on the entire region for at least part of the day from March to September. So let me discuss this part now. Region near to the poles, that is North Pole and South Pole, is called as polar region. As we know that polar regions are extremely cold. Here rainfall is very scanty, that means very less. And temperature is very low. Arctic regions are continuous cold around the North Pole. Here sun never shines during the winter. But from March to September, the sun shines entire region. Now I will read the next part. Greenland. Greenland is the largest island in the world. It is a province of Denmark. Though it is part of North America, it lies very close to the North Pole. It is only 710 kilometers from the North Pole. It lies about 2,090 kilometers away in the North Atlantic Ocean. At one point, the island is only 16 kilometers from Canada. The island is about 2,680 km in length and 1,280 km in width. Australia, which is larger than Greenland, is surrounded by water like island, but we call Australia as a continent, not as an island, because it is so very large. And I think you all know that Greenland is the largest island in the world. It is not a continent. It is in the North Atlantic Ocean. About 95% of this island is covered with ice throughout the year. It is very close to the North Pole. It is a province, which means a unit of a country or empire of Denmark. Means Greenland is a province of Denmark. And do you know who gave the name Greenland? Yes, the first European who visited Greenland was an explorer called Erik the Red. He gave the island its name. Greenland is itself governing province of Denmark. One more thing you have to know, that in your book, capital of Greenland is given as Gotland, but it is also called as nuk. Presently, people called it as nuk. N-U-U-K, nuk. Land surface. Greenland is a low island plateau surrounded by coastal mountains. The mountains are always covered with thick snow. In fact, except for the narrow coastal strips, about 4/5 of Greenland is covered with ice. This ice covering is known as ice cap. The ice cap averages over 1.6 kilometers thick and a thickness of over 3.2 kilometers has been measured. The surface of this ice cap looks like land. It has high ridges and deep crevasses. Often, bits of the ice cap break off and slide down the sloping land and fall into the sea. These floating blocks of ice are called icebergs. Due to the fog, one cannot see them from the distance. They are dangerous to ship because they are much bigger below the surface of seawater than they appear on the surface. Okay, now see. Greenland is an island surrounded by coastal islands. The Arctic Circle passes through the southern part of Greenland. Thus, most of this island lies in the frigid zone in the northern hemisphere. This region is also known as tundra region. What is it? Tundra region. T-U-N-D-R-A. Tundra region. 80% of Greenland is always covered with ice. The mountains are always covered with ice. This covering of ice is called ice cap. These ice caps are about 1.6 km to 3.2 km. It also has high ridges, means a long narrow hilltop mountain range, and deep crevasses, which means a deep open crack, especially on glacier. Do you know what is glacier? Glacier is a huge mass of ice that moves slowly down a slope or a valley. Sometimes what happens? Huge block of ice break off and float on the sea. They are called icebergs and are sometimes very dangerous to the ships in the sea, because when an iceberg floats on water, most of it remains underwater, which is very dangerous. Now come to the climate. See how is the climate of Greenland. Climate of Greenland is very cold, but it has been gradually growing warmer since the early 1900s. The coldest region in the center of the ice cap. The temperature averages minus 47 degrees Celsius in February and minus 11 degrees Celsius in July. The lowest temperature ever recorded in North America was minus 66 degrees Celsius in Greenland in 1954. As Greenland is the polar region, the sun's rays falling here are slanting. They do not heat up the surface of the earth so much. Besides this, the winter months are very long and dark. There are months of darkness in the winter. However, in the summer, there is continuous daylight. The sun shines even at midnight. Thus, the place is also called the land of the midnight sun. Despite the sunlight, the temperature rarely rises above freezing point. So, see, the climate of Greenland is very cold. Here, the average temperature is 47 degrees Celsius in February and -11 degree Celsius in July. In 1954, the lowest temperature was recorded in North America in Greenland, which was -66 degree Celsius. The southwestern part of Greenland is the warmed part of the country, and thus most of the people live there. Do you know why polar regions do not heat up very much? Because in the polar region, the sun's rays falls slanting as it is far away from the equator. And in Greenland, the winter months are very long and dark, where months of darkness in the winter. But in summer, there are continuous daylight. The sun even shines at midnight. Norway is a part of Greenland, is called as land of midnight sun. Now see the vegetation. The summer brings small shrubs and mosses. Short trees, only waist high, grow in Greenland. There are lichens, or you can say lichens, and many other flowering plants. There are also many berries. Okay, nothing grows in the ice-covered areas of Greenland. There are no forests and no crops grown. But plants like chaise, cotton, grasses, mosses, and lichens or lichens grows in southern Greenland during summer months. Animal life. The animal life of the region is surprisingly rich. The most common animals are reindeer and caribou. Among the smaller animals are wolves, foxes, hares, and wolverines, which feed mainly on ground squirrels, voles, and lemmings. These animals are protected against the cold by a thick, warm fur and a heavy layer of fat under the skin. There are few birds in the region. They live on or near the water, where they find their food. Every year, millions of ducks, geese, and wethers come here to nest and feed. Most animals are snow-colored. Seal, walrus, whales, and polar bears live in the sea here. In Greenland, only those animals that can withstand the extreme cold are found here. You see, animals like polar bear, reindeer, musk ox, wolves, hares, Arctic fox, seal, etc. are common. Several variety of fishes and seabirds are also found there. These animals can survive there because of thick, warm fur and heavy layer of fats under the skin. Every year, birds like ducks, geese, and wethers come for migration. And sometimes what happens? These birds starve to death as they waited for the snow to melt. Here, many animals are of snow colored. Polar bear and hare are two examples of snow colored animals.